Today on Anatomy.
So I lost my appendix, it had fully ruptured, and I had a big surgery. I was out of school for that semester to heal from everything.
Wow.
So I started working with a dietitian to rebuild my gut, my stomach, my digestion, all of that following the surgery. I've got 3 servings of fruit.
Okay.
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 We throw this on, we'd want to use a half,
okay,
because it's a little larger, and that would bring me to 5 servings.
Oh,
so do you
okay.
notice how I've only got 4 fruits?
Uh-huh.
But it's 5 servings.
Ah.
Okay.
Afro Global Television is a global super channel that transforms the destiny of people of African descent through programming that informs, empowers, entertains, and uplifts. The mission of Afro Global is to showcase the best of Africa and the diaspora.
Watch Afro Global Television on channel 2472 on Bell 5 and channel 708 on Rogers Cable.
Welcome to Anatomic. Today we have a dietitian from the Rexdale Community Health Center, Rebecca Nazareth. Welcome, Rebecca, to Anatomic.
Thank you so much for having me.
Tell us why you became a dietitian.
So my journey really started after high school when I started thinking about what I wanted to do for university. I was really passionate about athletics, I was passionate about music, I was passionate about the sciences, and my folks wanted me to actually become a doctor and go, you know, go that path, doctor, lawyer, or something in that field. Mm-hmm. I was a little reluctant, so I started an arts and science degree. And in my first year, I got really sick in the first semester of university.
Okay.
First exam I was preparing for, had a lot of stomach ache and kind of collapsed right before the exam. Next thing I knew, I woke up, I was in the ER, and it was appendicitis. So I lost my appendix, it had fully ruptured, and I had a big surgery. I was out of school for that semester to heal from everything.
Wow.
So I started working with a dietitian to rebuild my gut, my stomach, my digestion, all of that following the surgery. The antibiotics were really harsh and it changed my whole system.
Okay.
So that really started the journey towards
dietetics. Wow, now that's very interesting, because usually it takes an event for a lot of people to realize, hey, you know, I better do something here, right? So you decided you're going to become a dietitian after that experience.
Pretty much. Like, I saw the work she did and I saw the improvement and the power of food, using herbs, using spices, eating healthier, and really how you could fix your entire system and balance it out to feel a lot better. Nothing like pharmacy meds were doing for me, which is a quick fix, and nutrition did for me long term.
What does the job of a dietitian entail?
So,
you know, what does a dietitian really do?
Great question. So we actually work with the population in regards to health and nutrition,
mm-hmm,
to prevent disease.
Okay.
And we kind of work towards also, for instance, helping to prevent low birth weight babies,
okay,
the progression of certain diseases like diabetes, heart disease, cancer. And really, we are the in-between as far as quality of life through nutrition. And we work in different sectors. We work in community health centers like myself at Rexdale Community Health Center. And then you also have hospital dietitians. You have dietitians in private companies like
Cal. So
yeah.
Did you get to work with athletes like me, or?
So I have friends that are sports nutritionists that
work. And the reason why I say that is because for every successful athlete out there, you know, they have to have a dietitian, someone to help them eat properly and to make sure that, you know, that goes along with the training.
Yes, so dietitians are regulated under the College of Dietitians of Ontario. So we have a license and we pay annual fees. Uh-huh. And they usually have a degree and they've completed an internship,
okay.
So placement. Nutritionists, however, may have like a Bachelor of Science degree or a college certification,
okay.
Without the licensing component and mm-hmm. without the internship placement component.
Okay.
So two different fields. So yeah, now there's a variety. There's holistic nutritionists, sports nutritionists, and then there's dietitians.
Yeah.
But your safest bet, I would go with a dietitian because we take into consideration your medical history. We can work with doctors. We can look at the medications you're on as well.
So we already talked about how that event happened in your life. That's what made you become a dietitian.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, then that means that you haven't always been the type of person that always ate healthy.
That is correct. So
I don't say that in a bad way because I myself slip every now and then and I fall off the bandwagon, and guess what?
Yeah.
I have to learn to pick up and get back on it. So any experiences with that?
Definitely. I was overweight as a teenager. I loved candies, chocolates, pop, you name it. I actually grew up drinking Coca-Cola, of all things. Barely ate any fruits and veggie, and I actually changed. It was a 360 when I became sick.
Yeah.
So I think we all do it, and I think sometimes when you get diagnosed with something, that's when people really make a change, or something happens with disease in the family. And it is tough.
Yeah.
It is tough.
Yeah.
But really, it's a choice. You know, prevention or wait till you're diagnosed.
That's right.
Yeah.
So in reality, at the end of the day, then, you would say nutrition is very important for everybody. Now, what are the common mistakes that you find today everybody makes when it comes to nutrition?
I feel like people plan for a lot of things like retirement. People are saving for vacations or they're investing.
Uh-huh.
You know, they go see a financial advisor.
Okay.
Everybody goes to, you know, plan a party or gatherings or unions, mm-hmm. right? We plan parties, we plan our retirement, we plan for our kids. But I feel like health takes the back seat with your priorities. Like, rarely do I see someone going, okay, let me make my weekly meal plan.
Let me plan
my groceries, right? That's kind of last on the list.
And that's important, of course.
Exactly, exactly. So I think it's up there in priority. It's an investment in your health.
Mm-hmm.
And what good is planning for retirement if you haven't planned for your health? You know, you may not even get there.
And like, you know, on this show here, we like to talk about disease prevention, health maintenance, and health rehab.
Mm-hmm.
As a dietitian, how important is that when it comes to those three things?
Extremely important in terms of maintaining a healthy quality of life.
Yeah.
If you can prevent something like diabetes, for example, you know, you can avoid having amputations or losing your eyesight, you know, just doing that small prevention piece.
Yeah.
Same with a stroke. A stroke can be very debilitating and you can end up in a wheelchair, you know. So I think nutrition is very much up there with wellness, health and wellness, and your overall picture for quality of life.
We're going to take a break, and when we come back, Rebecca is going to talk to us about portions. Up next.
So quick rule of thumb you're going for is really looking for a full cup of greens or cooked vegetables, one dark, one orange per day.
Okay.
And you could have this in the form of a salad or you can have it in the form of a cooked vegetable.
Welcome back. We have with us dietitian Rebecca Nazareth. We have a lot of stuff on the table here. We're going to talk about portions today.
Excellent.
It's another thing to talk about nutrition and eating well, but it's another thing to talk about portions.
Yes.
What are we talking about when we're talking about portions?
Great question. What we're looking at is serving sizes versus portions.
Okay.
So I like to make people aware, as we do using Canada's Food Guide, we talk about getting you to know about food servings, mm-hmm. in order to understand if you should be having larger portions or small portions.
Okay.
It really depends on how many serving sizes you should be having.
So now you're talking about serving.
Yes.
So first, we're talking about portions. What's the difference? Is there a difference between servings and portions?
Yes. So somebody like you may need larger portions of protein, mm-hmm. than me. But
okay.
knowing, for example, your serving size, okay, my serving size for meat is the size of my palm,
uh-huh.
would enable you to know how many servings you need to know how much of a portion you should have.
Interesting.
That makes sense, yes.
Well, how do we control that then? How do we control the portions that we eat? And how does a person know how much to eat, by the way?
So Dietitians of Canada has developed for the Canadian population in 2007 a revised edition of Eating Well with Canada's Food Guide,
okay.
which provides a quick and easy tool as a guideline to show you how many serving sizes you should be having for
okay.
each food group.
Okay.
So I like to tell clients to think about the traffic light signal. So what colors do we have there? We've got
green,
there you go.
Yellow.
And red. And think of the sky, you've got blue.
Okay.
So once you know that, you've got your rainbow color of food groups.
Okay.
And then you open it up, which is what I'll show you today, is your actual serving sizes for each person based on your age and gender.
So it goes by age and gender?
Yes. So
okay.
That's exactly what we're looking at.
Now, here's the thing though. You're going out.
Mm-hmm.
You're eating out, you're working, you're out with friends. How do you control that? That becomes a very difficult thing to do.
Right. So quite easily, getting to know your serving sizes and learning how to substitute. For example, hey, I'm going out, I want to have cake tonight. What am I going to give up at maybe lunchtime or dinner time because I want to have cake? You might reduce your portion of carbohydrates,
yeah.
to be able to have dessert. Or if you're grabbing a wrap, knowing how to ask for dressings on the side. Salt, less salt in the deli meats maybe. Take on a grilled meat versus a ready-to-go meat. So there's little tips along the way, and you're really looking at fats, sugars, and salts when you have takeout food.
Now, do you want to show the viewers what a portion looks like and what a serving looks like?
Yes, I most certainly would love to. So let's take a look here. We've got vegetables, and what we're looking for is really half a cup of cooked vegetables.
And that would be a broccoli right there, is
yes,
that right?
Yes, broccoli, okay. half cup cooked,
uh-huh.
would be one serving.
Okay.
Okay. So quick rule of thumb you're going for is really looking for a full cup,
okay.
of greens or cooked vegetables,
mm-hmm.
One dark, one orange per day.
Okay.
And you could have this in the form of a salad,
okay.
or you can have it in the form of a cooked vegetable.
I see.
Okay. So quite easily, two handfuls.
Okay.
Okay. Now, you want to keep in mind there are some starchy vegetables that people might have.
Okay.
So for example, if you're having corn or peas,
mm-hmm.
or carrot, we want these to limit to about a half a cup.
Okay.
And then we want the dark leafy greens. You can have fun. You can go with a cup and a half. Very low.
And that's because the darker the vegetable is, the more nutrients I hear. Is that right?
So it's got
is
more
fiber.
Yes. So it's got more fiber.
Yeah.
And the colors, all of them will provide you with good amounts of vitamins,
mm-hmm.
And nutrients. However, these would contain more natural sugars, the
okay.
softer vegetables. Okay?
Okay.
So quite easily, a quick way to remember, two handfuls, you're looking at during meals.
Okay.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Right there next to it, we've got the fruits.
Okay.
Okay. So a quick rule of thumb we use is we say a tennis ball, a fruit this size, because
okay.
in today's stores, you can get this and you can get this.
That's
okay.
Right.
So you want to know your serving sizes. This is where we talk about serving sizes versus portions. Okay.
Okay? And, and you know what? That's really important for the viewers because that's where a lot of the confusion comes.
Exactly,
okay.
yes. So if you're looking at a larger fruit, you
okay.
want to go with a half.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're looking at a medium size, you can go with a full fruit.
Okay.
Something like grapes. Have you ever met somebody that can eat a whole bag of grapes?
Well, I could be guilty of that sometimes.
Okay, there
but,
you go. Yeah. Yes. So that would translate into sugar,
okay.
natural sugar, which can turn into fat if it's eaten in excess.
Okay.
okay?
Mm-hmm.
So this is about 15 grapes, which would be a portion of a serving of fruit for
okay.
you as one serving.
And
okay?
that would be a serving.
Yes.
Portion.
So right here, I've got three servings of fruit.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
We throw this on. We'd want to use a half because it's a little larger, and that would bring me to 5 servings. So do you notice how I've only got 4 fruits, but it's 5 servings? Okay? Because this counts for 2 fruits.
I see.
So very important to get to know your fruit serving sizes, and then from there, you can, you know, this is 4 servings. This would be all you'd need in a day. For someone like you or me,
let's go back to eating out.
Yes.
Okay. I went and I brought this.
Okay.
Shall we open it?
For sure.
You like my packaging?
Not so much.
Probably not. Okay. And we'll talk about that a little bit. But what can you tell me about this right here?
Okay.
Should I put it right here, maybe?
Awesome.
What do we have here?
Okay. So you've got what did you order?
I have some rice. I have some vegetables. And I have here some beef.
Okay, excellent. So what's going on there, if you notice, a larger portion is of rice, a smaller portion of vegetables, and a smaller portion of the proteins. What we're really aiming for is to transform that plate into this.
Okay.
Where the vegetables go to a half, your starch or grains.
So should we try that right now?
Well, that's okay, but just mental note, this is what we're looking for.
Mm-hmm.
And the problem with the food industry is rice and starch, these are really cheap foods for them to provide. The cost of vegetables is high, the cost of meat is high.
That's right.
So they will always serve it to you like that, and it's very rare you're gonna get the food industry to change that.
Uh-huh.
So it's really up to you to maybe have half of it and take the rest home for another meal.
Mm-hmm.
Or you could really just try to include a salad on the side and save some rice for later.
Rebecca, let's talk about carbs. Me as an athlete, especially a bodybuilder, carbs are very important to me. And I see you have something here. What is this here? I recognize this, but our viewers might not.
So this is an Ethiopian dish called injera.
Uh-huh.
And it's made of teff flour, and it's got whole wheat flour as well, and some barley flour.
Yeah.
If you look at the portion, it's quite large.
That's right.
And it is shared between the people that are eating it.
Uh-huh.
And they load it on with different...
Usually you have people surround that table.
Exactly,
and,
exactly.
You know.
So great for the dining experience. However, how much carbohydrates are you getting, and how much sugar is that breaking down into?
Okay.
So the rule of thumb we use is the fist size.
Okay.
That's what you want to go for your carbs. So if you look here, we've got a cup of rice.
Okay.
Okay. And you would really just take your fist at home, put it into a bowl,
okay,
and fill that up. So that's how much would be your portion.
And that would be a portion of the rice that you should be having.
Yes, a serving size at a meal.
Okay.
Okay?
Uh-huh.
So if you're going for rotis and things, you'd look for something like this.
Okay.
Between 2 to 3 servings, depending on your age and gender.
Okay.
Okay, based on the food guide. Muffins, they used to be like this, 200 mm-hmm. calories, and now they're huge.
Okay.
So you want to think about...
a lot of the time they look huge, but it's really just the top. The bottom is skinny.
Exactly,
so.
Right?
Yeah.
So that could be tricky. So you want to look for portions of that.
Uh-huh.
Cooked cereal, you want to look for 30 grams as one serving.
Okay.
Okay, in a bowl like this. And pasta, that would be a third of a cup.
And that's a favorite for a lot of people.
Exactly.
I know.
So all of these, you would just look at fist size and throw them in there. Okay. Very important to use half of your carbohydrates as whole grains. So here we've got some buckwheat.
Okay.
Okay, and we've got quinoa.
Okay.
So these are excellent alternatives to rice, because rice tends to be the norm.
That's
rice
right.
and pasta,
yeah.
right? Quick and easy. But you want to try to use alternative grains like quinoa, barley, buckwheat, in order to get more fiber.
But a lot of the time, it's because rice is very accessible.
Yes.
Easily everywhere. Can
yes.
people access these things at the grocery store?
They can. Nowadays, we've got everything in the grocery stores. You can go to Bulk Barn. You can go to the actual grocery store and get them in bulk. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Places like Costco as well.
Okay.
You want to use a variety. You don't want to kind of be stuck on just rice and pasta.
I'm really enjoying this session. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. Up next...
we want to avoid deep frying and your fried chicken kind of thing.
It tastes good, but
it does
taste not
good.
Always the best thing.
Yes, yes. So in terms of heart disease, not a great idea.
That's right.
So we would limit that to maybe once a month or as a treat.
Yeah.
And then we want to look at alternatives too. So nuts and pulses as well could be a great alternative.
Afro Global Television is a global super channel that transforms the destiny of people of African descent through programming that informs, empowers, entertains, and uplifts. The mission of Afro Global is to showcase the best of Africa and the diaspora.
Watch Afro Global Television on channel 2472 on Bell 5 and channel 708 on Rogers Cable.
Welcome back. So Rebecca, we left off talking about carbohydrates, but you have in your hands there, we have dairy.
Yes.
Can we talk about that?
Yes, definitely. So this is the Milk and Alternatives group, and we're really recommending a serving of dairy would be something like a cup of milk, 3/4 cup of yogurt, or 50 gram, 1.5 ounce of cheese.
Okay.
What you're looking for in this group is to use dairy products that are lower in fat. So for milk, you're looking for skim 1% or 2%.
Okay, you're staying away from the HOMO.
Exactly. Okay. The HOMO would only be needed for an infant that's about under 2 years old.
Okay.
And then for yogurts, you're looking for up to 2% milk fat, or MF.
Okay.
And for cheese, you're looking for under 20% milk fat. So the skim cheeses, the low-fat cheddar, mozzarella, those types of items. Don't be afraid to experiment with alternative dairy groups as well.
Yeah.
So things like kefir could be perfectly fine to use.
Okay.
Including at least 2 servings for some age groups.
Now, what about someone who's lactose intolerant?
Excellent question.
Are there any options?
Excellent question. So that's why we say milk and alternatives.
Yeah.
For people that are lactose intolerant and do not want to use dairy or cow's milk, there's a whole wide variety of nut milks that are now available.
Uh-huh.
So you get almond milk, you get rice milk as well, and you also get goat's milk and cheeses, as in goat cheese.
Yeah.
So you want to tap into these different varieties instead of jumping to like a lactate tablet as a solution, right? You could always include. The one thing to be aware of with that is the nut milks cannot always provide all of the vitamins and minerals.
Okay.
So you don't want to provide that right off the bat.
So you might have to resort to multivitamins or something of that.
You may have to, but we try to get everything from food first.
Okay. Now, what about proteins?
Excellent question. So the last group here, before we get into the fats, is the red group, or what we like to call the meats and alternatives.
Okay.
So this would include all of your meats. We want to go with lean meats, trim off all visible fats. So for chicken, for red meat, and fish, and as well burgers, we want to try to grill, roast more often.
That's right.
We want to avoid deep frying and your fried chicken kind
of
thing.
It tastes good, but
it does taste
not
good.
Always the best thing for you.
Yes. So in terms of heart disease, not a great idea.
That's right.
So we would limit that to maybe once a month or as a treat.
Yeah.
And then we want to look at alternatives too. So nuts and pulses as well could be a great alternative. Okay. So serving size for something like nuts, you're looking at about 1/4 cup.
Yeah.
Okay. It can have a lot of calories, so we want to make sure we watch our serving size. And with pulses, you're looking at about 1/2 cup.
Yeah.
With the meats, you're looking for a deck of cards or the size of your palm.
Okay.
Okay. So you could put that onto your palm.
Okay.
So it'd be a little bit bigger than that.
And that would be a serving or a portion?
Exactly.
Okay.
So for you, you'd probably be looking at protein like that. Okay.
That's because of all my muscles, eh?
Possibly, right? So a much bigger amount of protein, right?
Okay.
So for muscle function, excellent. But be sure to use red meat no more than a few times, and use fish as well, twice a week. So here you see you've got like eggs, nuts, and as well we want to use fish twice a week.
I love beans for protein.
Excellent.
Yeah.
So it's great. Like I make a stew with ground meat, ground beef, and half beans.
Yeah.
So that's a way to cut down your saturated fat for meat all the time and include more fiber from the pulses or
that's
the beans.
That's why I love chili. Chili is not...
It's an excellent food. Yes.
Now, what about fats? People always give fats a bad name. We always talk about that, but I know fats are good for you.
Yes.
Right? And can you share that with the viewers?
Definitely. So fats can help you lubricate your joints.
Uh-huh.
They also transport a lot of fat-soluble vitamins.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't have fats in your diet, you're really doing a lot of damage. Yeah,
plus, that's where you get most of your energy. Is that right?
It is higher at the highest in calories. So a tablespoon of fat would contain about 140 calories.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So a couple of creamers in your coffee every day would be like adding a tablespoon of oil.
Oh.
And you could easily gain weight with that. So we have hidden fats in food. Foods and in creamers.
So you just want to add enough fat to get that viscosity, but not to get fat. Is that
exactly,
right?
Exactly. Exactly.
Viscosity in those joints.
Yeah,
right?
But lubrication.
You don't want it sitting in the abs.
Exactly.
Okay.
And the way it seeps in there is through the hidden foods, right?
That's
so
right.
If you can keep an eye out, we recommend usually 2 to 3 tablespoons, which looks like this, of unsaturated fats. So you could use plant oils, so canola oil, olive oil. You could use sunflower, corn
coconut oil.
Coconut oil as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, what you want to be aware of is palm oil and coconut oil would be saturated fats.
Is that right?
Okay. Yes.
So, and that's because they settle and they actually become solid. Is
exactly.
that right?
Exactly. If you look on the shelf, you notice that they're white and hard.
Yeah.
And what we want to do with those saturated fats is limit it to about less than 10% of our fat intake.
Okay.
So we want to use more unsaturated plant flowy
so
oils.
So very important to be aware of that.
Yes. But something like coconut could be great for high heat.
Mm.
And olive oil, not so much. Olive oil will go in salads or heat under 350 degrees in the oven. And then we'd use more canola, corn, coconut, a variety of oils. So the best thing I say is change up your oils. Don't get stuck on the same oils. You can also
because you have options.
Yeah.
Olive oil, all those things.
Exactly.
In there, yeah.
Also
I
sesame.
I personally like to cook with peanut oil.
Yeah, that's excellent.
Yeah.
I use mustard oil. There's also sesame oil, avocado oil. So those are oils that we can definitely include in our
And you know
diet.
What I like about peanut oil?
What do you like
about
it?
You can actually fry fish and cook something with it. It won't transfer the smell over.
Oh, that's
Did you know
excellent.
That?
I didn't know that.
Hey,
cook, yeah,
you learn something
great
new every time. Thank you so much, Rebecca. You've shared so much wonderful information with our viewers. And I hope you've been listening because this is some information that will help you lead a very healthy lifestyle. And Rebecca, I do hope you come again. And thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.